Hello again. So I decided my video for Switzerland could benefit from narration as well, like the Rome one. This one won't need as much. I think I did a pretty good job of narrating as I went, but I have a couple of things I wanted to add. So yes, so from Rome, I drove to Switzerland. I do not recommend doing that unless you have another person to drive with. It can be done alone or with a cat. Not bad for a girl in a hat, but yeah. So I stayed for about a week in a house in Tolochenaz. I am never confident that I pronounced that right, but I was a couple minutes walk from Audrey's place, La Paisible. On my first day there, I took a walk down towards the lake looking for some food. It was a little difficult as a vegetarian, but settled on some pizza. It was okay. Expensive, but okay. Let's see. Yes, I will show you around Morges first, and then I'll take you to the farmer's market there, which Audrey liked to go to. And fun fact, her wedding was on a Saturday, and it was a market day. So it was during the market time. Just something I read while I was at the Exposition Bowl. I'm so sorry. That was a fun fact I read while I was there, actually. So I will take you to that exhibit, which ended September 12th, I think. So you've missed it. This is your only chance to see anything from it. then I will show you a bit of Lausanne as well. It's a much bigger city, and I was only there for an hour or two. I was going to a French conversation meetup. So there's a little video from Lausanne, and then I go for a little walk around Tolochenaz and talk to you about something important. So enjoy.
Morning in Morges. Actually, it's noontime. I'm looking for lunch. This is the view from my room right now. So here's the market in Morges. Wednesdays and Saturday mornings. I've got nice soaps and bags. I'm not getting my car, so I can't buy one. All sorts of good things. Apparently Audrey would come here regularly. I mean, how could you not? So we're gonna walk out. Again, after the market's over, I'm gonna go see this exhibition over here. But first, does anyone recognize this building? This is where she got married to Andrea. So I should probably stop and take a picture. And we continue on. Actually, I have to look at the map. I'm not exactly sure where I'm going. Alright, here we are. This see another exhibit here. I was here 2 years ago. It's crazy. Castles everywhere. That's part of why I love Europe. I have to confess that exhibition left me a little depressed. It was good. No, it's nothing to do. I mean, yes, I wish I would have met her, but I'm jealous. I'm envious. Just all the great movies she got to make and all the people she got to work with. And here I am, mid-30s, and I have nothing I'm proud of. I'm sorry for everyone I worked with. I'm sorry. I mean, I have short films and background work and stand-in work and things I had fun with, but no feature-length films that I am proud of. Anything I've really worked on, a real film. I'm getting white hair, and I just don't know if I'll ever get to work. So, a little depressed. She got to work on so much wonderful stuff, and I haven't. But she was special. And is that a turtle? It is! Okay, hold on. It's just a turtle eating a salad. Oh, it's so cute. Okay, that has nothing to do with Audrey, sorry. But I hope you enjoyed that turtle break. I did. I'm gonna leave Morges in a minute. I'm in a bit of a funk now, just thinking about acting work. I don't want to be as famous as Audrey or anything. I just want to work on good films with great crews and directors and actors, and make things that will be remembered and loved, and but that is difficult. It takes a lot of luck, I guess. Sometimes I wonder if I'm any good. I don't know. I can't judge that. Got a Best Actress nomination once, but yeah. So anyway, right now I've been living vicariously through Audrey and doing this trip as part of my, mission, goal, campaign to play Audrey. But, I don't know, just having a moment now. It'll pass. I'll be fine. But if you have a good script, send it over. Alright, I'm gonna go now. So I'm in Lausanne right now. I'm not sure how much walking around I'm gonna get. I'm going to a French conversation meetup tonight to practice French. But yeah, this is Lausanne. I'm so far from the lake. Last time I was here, I was closer to the lake, and it's really lovely down there. But we'll see. Let's see what I can share with you in the next hour. Cute little urban garden. Ooh, raspberries. Oh, I can't wait to have a garden. I really want raspberries. I apologize. I'm going to try to talk right into the phone. You know, my audio has not been that great. It's a special little place right here. I want to have a garden all year round. Not a winter person, me. That's when our meetup is going to happen. We're going to practice our French. An hour.
Right, how are you liking the city? It's a lot bigger than Morges. I have to head back to my French meetup, but I hope you enjoyed this little area of the city. There's so much more. There's the lakeside area, which I remember being quite lovely last time I was there. So I definitely recommend visiting this city, but be warned. Things are a bit more expensive here than everywhere else I've been. So save up if you want to come to Switzerland. Or just, I don't know, donate. Okay, so off to my meetup. See you later.
So, alright, going for a little walk. The little town whose name I can't pronounce right. Maybe someday. Kind of taking the long way around. I'm gonna go to Audrey's house. And then I want to talk to you about something important. So here's a little church. I believe her sons were baptized here. Or at least one of them. Maybe I'll come for a Sunday service. It's pretty cute. I feel a bit stalkerish. such an adorable house. I don't know how stalkerish I want to get here. I don't want to get caught. Not like I'm doing anything illegal, I guess, but who wants weirdos checking out their house all the time? So, this is next door, and I don't know if it was her property or not, but we gotta have a talk about this.
So, I learned today that the owner of this property is submitting plans to split the property in half and use the far half and this orchard to develop into housing for 600 people. I can imagine the neighborhood would not be pleased with that. I'm not. It's a gorgeous property. I will show you over the fence if I can. But yeah, I've always admired that. It's just the perfect property. It's a gorgeous big house. It's peaceful. It's got a giant yard next to an orchard here. It's wonderful. I love it. And not to mention that it's Audrey's and it should be a protected area, I think. But, yeah. I'm told within the next decade or so, if he gets permission, this will happen. So, I am going to do what I can to start or join a petition, do a protest. I don't know. Can I get the townspeople on board? I'm sure they'd join in. I don't know. I'm not sure. But I know there are a lot of important things, a lot of important issues in the world to deal with. But if this gets destroyed, then that's it. It's gone. We can't undo it. And it's such a small thing that I think we can accomplish, you know? We can stop the development of a small corner of the world. And so I want to do what I can. If you want to join me, let me know. And also, I remember this hedge being a lot shorter, because I came here in 2004 and was able to stand on the hood of our rental car and look over it. And that's not possible now.
Oh no, they're pears. Oh, I love pears. Sorry, not apples. Pears, even better. Alright, let's see if we can see. I'm gonna try over here too. And now for some real fun, we're headed to the cemetery. Oh, and I remembered the word I keep looking for, landmark. Historical landmark, or location of significance, or yes, something like that. That's what we should make our house, so they can't develop on it. So people are constantly leaving things here. I've done it before. I forget what I left. I left a little potted plant with a message written on the pot. Much love and many thanks, I think I said, for, you know, being inspiring. Bought a little Yorkie to leave here once, but I don't think I ever got here with it. I might have. I don't remember. But always new flowers, new pictures.
Alright, little old lady came to visit someone else in the cemetery, so I'll let her have the place to herself now. And I'm gonna head back home before it starts raining again or something. So I hope you enjoyed that little tour, and I'll talk to you again soon. By the way, since we're on the topic of cemeteries, whoever's in charge of my funeral and burial, please make it eco-friendly. Don't embalm me. Don't take me to an undertaker. That's horrible. Have a nice cardboard box that everyone can doodle on, you know, and take me home where, you know, family and friends can give me a mani-pedi and do my makeup. Something old-fashioned like that, and then eco-friendly burial somewhere with a really cute little rock with my name carved in it, you know. I don't have a will, so I'm just putting it out there so somebody can take charge. I should maybe make a will.
This is a nice little cafe Audrey came to. Let's see, a visit to that here in town. My last day here, and I'm about to get on the road. So talk to you later.
So a few days after making that video where I tell you about those development plans for La Paisible, I got in touch with a couple people in the community who had more information on this plan to divide and develop. And so here is what I know so far. The plan was proposed last year and voted down by the community. So at the moment, the property is safe. There's nothing urgent right now, but it's not protected forever. The plan will probably be proposed again and again and again until it's done. This could be soon, it could be in a couple years, but it's not protected. So I've been talking with these people, and I'll get on a phone call with somebody soon to chat more about this. And I've been brainstorming and talking about, well, what if the town owned the property, you know, what could be done with it? Or what if we petitioned to have it designated as a site of historical significance or something like that? And I proposed that whatever we're doing, we could reach out to the fan base, because there are millions of people, thousands of whom would surely sign a petition showing how much we care about protecting this property. And they like that idea. So even though nothing needs to be done right now, I don't know how quickly things will move if the plan gets proposed again or if any legal action needs to be taken. So I'm setting up an email list. So anyone who's interested in getting news right away or getting the petition right away, if this needs to be done or when this needs to be done, you can sign up on the email list. Just check the description below this video for the link. And if I have news, then I can immediately inform you, and hopefully, you know, we'll save Audrey's house. I don't want to say house. The house is fine. It's the property that would be destroyed. And the neighborhood, really. You saw how wonderful and peaceful it really is there. And to imagine so many apartment buildings being built, it really would change the whole town. So even if I don't live there, I do care. So if you care to, sign up and we will save Audrey's house. Okay, so that's it for Switzerland. And now I have to work on my Holland video. So much work to do. I hope you appreciate this. It's fine. Okay, so don't forget to follow me. Wow, what kind of accent was that? Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I'm posting a lot of pictures there, and my adventure continues. Always, my life is an adventure, so.